Hello, my name's Tom Rudd and I'm playing Sergeant John Kaufman. He doesn't really want to be in charge. His mate, Corporal O'Keefe, was supposed to have been in command, but he got injured, so he kind of jumped over him, and he doesn't really want it, and all he wants to do is get everybody through and get home, and he doesn't care about any problems along the way.
Hi there, my name is Rami Helmi. I'm playing the character of Eddie O'Keefe. He's the corporal, which is the second in command. Basically my character is the quiet guy who's the thinker more than the talker, and obviously watching the back of all the squad, the team, you know, the second backup for the sergeant himself, and always covering the rear stuff.
Hi, I'm James Fisher. I'm playing Robert Schaefer. My character, he's a bit of an alcoholic, unfortunately. He's got a bit of a drink problem, but under the circumstances, I think that's not too difficult to understand. He's Bryant's good friend in the squad. He's one of the guys that Bryant can trust and relies on to help see him through. Yeah, and I think they both lean on each other a little bit. And Schaefer's got a big problem, obviously with the drink, but also a bit of his backstory is that he threw a grenade into a room and blew up three kids and their mother, so he's racked with guilt, hence the bad drinking problem.
Hello, my name's Dominic Coddington. I'm playing Private Chris Rudman. My character is the main antagonist in this film. He's the person who gets up everybody's arse. Basically, he's a bit of a psycho. He's from the deep south. And he goes around loosing and pillaging and raping.
So my name is Myriam Tisler and I play a French woman, and the American planes have just blown up her parents' farms. Her parents are dead. She gets captured, and when she comes out she realizes that her German lover is dead. She was a kind of collaborator, although I think she just fell in love with the guy, and she gets raped and then she dies. It's the hell of a day.
I'm just here as a fat German, which you never see every day, helping a friend out.
He's asked me to come along and just come in as be a German. They're a bit short of Germans. I like playing Germans.
Yeah, today we're going to do, it's our first scene with some German armour, so that'll be interesting.
Then yesterday was my first day that I was carrying a lot of heavy equipment, the BAR, all the webbing and everything, and I've actually got a very bad back today because of it, and just carrying it around and being very uncomfortable in all this kit. And I actually remember in the middle of a scene thinking to myself, how unfortunate I am at the moment for carrying all this crap, and then getting a sudden sense of, you know, how these guys must have felt.
Well, I think one of the things that I've realise more than anything else is just how, I mean, A, how fit they must have been, because the stuff they have to carry is just, it's just ridiculous.
And the feeling of this is just amazing, you know, I mean, like doing it a few days, it's been, I mean, absolutely a killer, and we're not even carrying all the heavy equipment the way they used to carry in the old days in the World War II.
We've got like these ammo pouches which are just full of these rubber little sort of replica ammo things, and you know, and so sort of got our webbing on and our fake rubber guns, and that's heavy enough, and you know, well, I mean, we can like put them down in between shots and whatever, and these guys, it's, I mean, they just must have had balls of steel.
You know, I've got no right to actually say I know how it feels at all, but I got a bit of a sense of how it might feel on the first day when we was actually doing a scene right here with these two graves. They don't look much now, but at the time that there was smoke coming across, there was the rifles with the helmets in them. It's a very emotional scene, and yeah, it's sort of I've got a tingle down my spine and a slight sense of the emotions and mental torture and anguish that they must have been going through.
Just the thought that you could get killed any minute, you know, you're walking along, you might just tread on a mine.
You know, all you can really do is, you know, have a bit of respect for the, you know, the characters that you're playing.
Well, Rick, he's an inspiration to us all. He's a true, true leader of men.
Rick is very dedicated to the actual subject. He's got a huge interest in it, as have I. He supplies all this equipment. He's helped out on Band of Brothers, so he's got a lot of good experience.
He's having to do everything himself, like he's directing, he's producing, he's written the thing. He's even letting me stay at his flat. He's, you know, his girlfriend's had to leave, so she's staying somewhere else for a couple of days because she doesn't want to live with three smelly guys in this small one-bedroom flat, which is fair enough.
Yeah, he thought he could make a very good film, and you know, I had a lot of confidence in him, that he could. And being here on the shoot and that, I've got no reason to think otherwise. Things been very good. There's been a few curveballs thrown at him, and he's, you know, dealt with them very well.
Yeah, no, he's a really good bloke, and he's a really good director as well. He's really chilled out. He keeps everybody on track, you know, but he gets the whip out if people start acting up.
There's a fair chance that the blooper reel could be longer than the actual film, because there's been some classics.
He loves it, doesn't he?
The professional attitude of everybody, the cast, the crew, the director, you know? I mean, I would say this is going to be a pretty good film. It's going to be pretty awesome. And I'm looking forward when this all finishes and edit it together and watch it. So, you know, he's doing a great job.